Okay, so in the next, it's probably going to take two videos to get through this, but I want to get after some concepts associated with resampling, which is going to come up kind of a number of times. It's going to come up, I think, when we do the Mama Raster, and it will probably also, I'll mention it when I talk about Viewshed. So it's kind of an important concept, this idea of resampling. Fair enough. And the basic problem is that if we have this raster, what we'd like to do sometimes is change the cell size or somehow change the spatial structure and figure out how to bring the values over from this one to fill out this new raster. Is that fair? So in this example I'm going to give, we're just going to be changing the cell size. The extent is going to stay the same. So it's a relatively simple case, but that's our issue, is how do we basically change the cell size of a raster and decide what values to populate these new cells. This may seem pretty straightforward, but I'm going to talk about two different ways of doing it. So here's a bigger picture, right? And so the idea is we have column 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, row 1, 2, 3, 4. And we're going to want to go to here. So now this is all was column 1. This was column 2, 3, 4, 5. And this was all 1, this was 2, this was 3, and this was 4. And I'm going to focus on the problem of this cell right here, which is basically the right one, the third right column, and the third top row. So third right, third top, I think it's this guy right here, which is the one I'm going to focus on. And the idea is that I want to show you how you come up with a new value for here based on the old values that are in here, right? So our context is that we're surrounded by these areas. And we know a value for basically here, 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 and here. Is that fair? That we have ones that were here, 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 and here. Okay, so let me see if I can grab, I think I have a red pen someplace. Sorry. Okay, so we're trying to figure out this guy, right? And we know values for these places, right? We know that this guy had the value 1, this kind of location in the old. We know that this guy had the value of 0 in the old. We know that this guy had the value of 1. And we know that this guy had the value of 1. And so the first, so let's keep going here. And so the idea is that this guy, I'm going to call A, because I think he's closest, right? A is basically the nearest value in the old, in input, from here to here. And then if we keep going here, I think these guys and these guys are a little bit further. So we call B is basically a little further. And then this guy, furthest. Is that fair so far? And I think you can, is that okay to do that? I mean, one way to kind of figure that out is just to draw kind of triangles. And this hypotenuse, I think, is a little bit smaller than that one. But this guy is probably the longest. Is that fair? But we're after, you know, not to kind of make this too complicated, and but it is a little bit complicated. So we're after these guys are the distances that we're interested in. And this one seems to be shortest. This guy is a little bit longer. And then this guy is furthest. So one method that we could do is called the nearest neighbor. And what nearest neighbor is basically going to do is just take the kind of the nearest value in the input, right? So if we use the nearest neighbor for this, the nearest value is the one that's separated by A, which is 1, so we would just stick a 1 there. Is that fair? So the alternative is to use bilinear kind of interpolation, which is basically what, if you use this method to kind of come up with a new value for this, the idea is that you're going to look at the four neighbors and basically take a portion of the value based on its distance. So with a bilinear, you would take more from this one. You would take basically the most portion of this one. You would take a little bit less from these two, and you would take the least from this, but you would take some. So the idea is that this is a distance weighted average. Okay? And so let me kind of cruise around here trying to find some notes. The math for this, I'm happy to kind of talk to you about in office hours if you're interested in it. But if we used this result, that this value would be equal to 1. If we used this method, it's going to be not 1, it'll be a little bit less than 1, because we're going to take a little bit of the 0 and average that in, right? So in this case, I think the answer would be 0.9375 is what we'd wind up putting here, right? Because we're going to take, you know, most of what we're going to take an average, but rather than just dividing by 4, we're going to weigh the amount that we take based on the distance. Is that fair? So I think I'm going to stop here and then show you some examples of this.